Can you hear me?
Good.
Okay, excellent. Council General, Mayor of Ballarat Council, Councillors, Members of Parliament, Members of the Executive Team, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to all of you. It is wonderful to see everyone gathered here today for Australia Day. My name is Hong Kong and I thank you for inviting me here to Ballarat to be your Australia Day Ambassador. I'm fascinated by your city, on which gold was built, known for its history, diversity, culture and colonial era heritage. Just look at this building, the mining exchange. Isn't it just beautiful? As you know, my background is one of the medical specialist radiologists and nuclear medicine physician, where I have the honor of being the first woman in Victoria to do both. In case what you're wondering, so what sort of doctor am I? I'm the specialist doctor who figures out exactly what is wrong with you by reading your X-ray, ultrasound, PET scan, MRI, bone scan, and the like, and then I write a radiology report to your GP or any other referring doctor to let them know. You probably never need me because I'm the doctor in the background, the doctor to the other doctors. In what is now the start of the third year of the COVID pandemic, I dedicate this public address to the healthcare workers and other emergency service workers who have tirelessly followed through this pandemic, to those who have died during this time. I also dedicate this address to my extended family all over the world and to friends who have inspired me and helped me with the invasion of this address. I start my address by reading excerpts from two different books. The first excerpt is from an Italian novel written in Florence in the year 1350 approximately. I will now quote from it. People are dying day and night, and more like animals than human beings. They meet their ends in the lanes or in their homes, or among the crops that they were growing, with no doctor trying to help them, and no servants to look after them. Thus, they let things go. Stop bothering with the physicians or with the normal tasks. It is as though they were expecting death to arrive any moment now, and saw no point in any of the work they've done in the past. But instead, put all their efforts into consuming whatever was opening their way. The second excerpt is from a different book, a biography that was written in the early 20th century. As the visitors entered the town, they could sense an air of tenseness and foreboding amongst the inhabitants. Everywhere there was loud talk and whispers of fever, bloodletting, and sudden death, of corpses abandoned by roadsides and open fields. So, does this sound like a pandemic to you? Yes. Was it COVID-19? No. The first quote is from a book written in the 1350s, 700 years ago, that details Italian, the Florentine panic. The second quote was from a biography detailing the year 1910, 100 years ago, about the Northern Chinese plague. The difference from our situation, well, both books were about the plague, not COVID-19. However, there are much more similarities than we expect. These are the similarities. Number one, the plague happened before the discovery of antibiotics and treatment, same as the COVID pandemic. There is currently no known treatment to cure the disease. Two, we share the same feelings of trepidation, of tenseness and foreboding. Personal friend, friend, family, community. It doesn't matter whether it's the plague or it's COVID. It doesn't even matter when or where this pandemic is occurring. Three, in the 1910 plague, the second biography, the second quote I talked about, this was happening in China. And people also wore masks there. Some even wore them wrongly. I quote from the biography. Some were worn around the neck, like amulets, thus exposing both nostrils and mouth, the very organs that they should protect. Very similar to some of the way some people in Australia wear their stay over the nose and the mouth. But I've got news for you, because that's how cold it gets, by the nose and mouth, and never by the chin. So stop burning down the chin. 4. Our pandemic will also come to an end, even though it is hard to believe that while we're living in the middle of this, just like the plague in history, this pandemic will also finish. Don't lose sight of the big picture. 5. Human sentiments are the same, regardless of country, culture, time, and history. Because at the end of the day, we all belong to the same human race. Then and now, there were and continue to be people who obey the government mandates. Then and now, there were and continue to be the naysayers. In Dr. Wu's time, this is the biography from the second quote that I gave you. In Dr. Wu's time, there was a prominent French physician by the name of Dr. Messner, who didn't believe in mask wearing, despite being warned to do so. Upon his arrival in China, Dr. Messner insisted on seeing the lay patients, but without the mask. So what happened to him? He fell ill and died from the plague several days later. So what is this context of this 1910 plague that I'm talking about? Dr. Wu, just 31 years old at this stage, led the fight against the deadly pneumonic plague outbreak in Manchuria, which is in northern China. Dr. Wu was born in British Malaya. He was an English speaker and Cambridge University's first Asian heritage medical graduate. Facing an airborne disease that kills nearly 100% of the people he infects, Dr. Wu was given broad authority over the local doctors, over the police, over the military, over the civil officers. As a result, he was able to end the outbreak within 3 months of his arrival in the affected area in China. In 1935, he was nominated for the Nobel Prize in Medicine. Dr. Wu was also the inventor of the precursor of the N95 mask, the specialized mask that doctors, nurses, and all those people who take care of us wear during our COVID pandemic. Why do I know so much about this man? Because Dr. Wu was my ancestor. We are a five-generation medical dynasty. In 2020, when our pandemic started, I found and united 22 known living medical descendants of Dr. Wu Lien Teh, living in 14 different cities, 4 different countries, ranging from the age of 21 to 84 years of age. I organized the inaugural, the first meeting of the medical descendants of Dr. Wu by video conferencing, where all English speakers. But we all have different accents because we all live in different places. There is a Australian accent, the Californian accent, the English accent, the Irish accent, the Scottish accent, the Australian accent, and the Malaysian accent. Then we, the descendants, collaborated to honor Dr. Wu's lifelong work in public health, culminating in 3 publications in 3 different countries. My American cousin emailed me the other day to thank me for bringing all of us relatives together for strengthening the family ties. It brought tears to my eyes because I don't think I really did very much. It only seems minuscule compared to the day-to-day valid habits of those who work in intensive care units, in hospitals, Victoria, Australia, the world over, caring for COVID patients as